Have you heard the saying, interviewers make up their mind in the first 5 seconds? Well, that's sort of true. Interviewers make up their mind after your introduction. That makes a huge impact. Let's learn how to make a great introduction in your interviews today. Hi, I'm Ajit from Capshine. Capshine is a revolutionary Learn It Together English fluency program. With Capshine, learning English is easy, quick, fun, affordable, and effective. And we promise a whole new you in 6 months or less. Let's look at what interviews are all about, and more importantly, how to make a great impression. So what do people look for in an interview? What do interviewers look for in an interview? Well, two things essentially. One, your attitude, and of course two, are you a good fit? This is of course after they've already looked at your profile and they've decided that you probably have the technical skills to make it to the role. They just want to make sure everything is right and that you have certain things that will make you a good fit. And the introduction that you give can have a huge impact on that, because that's where it all starts from, and things can go downhill very quickly if your introduction goes wrong. So what are the components of a good introduction? Well, here they are. First, of course, is to greet them, right? You don't want to just sit down and start the conversation. You want to greet them as soon as you meet them. You introduce your name, maybe also from where you are, your experience, of course, some of your qualifications and achievements, and of course, skills that you have that are relevant to the position you're interviewing for. And finally, a little bit of closing to make it all come together. Remember that when you're going to the interview, you read the job description and know exactly what the role is. If you have questions, you should ask these, but after you've introduced yourself. Great, let's look at each of these parts one after the other. So the first thing you need to do is, of course, greet. How do you greet them? You walk into the interview, they ask you to sit down, or even before that, you'd want to essentially introduce who you are and get to know who the other person is. So a good format to use is start with a good morning, if it's morning. If it's anywhere up to 12 p.m. in the afternoon, use good morning. After that, up to around 3 to 4 p.m., you can say good afternoon. And after that, all the way to midnight, say good evening. Do not say good night, because good night is used, it doesn't really matter whether it's evening or night. Good night is used to say goodbye instead, right? So when you're leaving, maybe you can say good night, but do not greet someone with a good night. Great, you've given your first sort of greeting. The next step is to talk about yourself, your name, and where you're from. So my name is, your name. Do not say myself, this is incorrect. Myself, Ajit, is incorrect. My name is Ajit is correct. Or I am Ajit, P.O. Francis. Ideally use the full name if it's a very, very corporate, very structured organization, or give your first name if it's a more casual, if it's a more startup-like environment. I am from, so I'm from Chennai or Bangalore, wherever it is that you're from, and that should get you started with introducing yourself. The next thing you do, of course, is talk about your experience. So hi, I'm Ajit, I am from Chennai, and then you go into what you're doing right now, what you've done so far, the company you've been working with, for how long you've worked with it, and of course your total years of experience, the responsibilities and the kind of impact you've had. All of these come together to give you a good professional introduction. So let's sort of put it all together and see how that sounds. Hi, I'm Ajit, I'm from Chennai. I've been a teacher at Capshine for 2 years now. With Capshine, me and my team designed and launched the Capshine Learn It Together program, and it's been a great success. These are a great way to introduce yourself. Notice how you made a very impactful first impression in the first few seconds itself. You, your name, your location, what you've been doing, and the quick impact that you've had in the last few years. Let's take this forward and see what we can derive out of this. But before that, let me quickly talk about the Capshine Learning Program. With Capshine, you get a 30-day free trial, no risk, where you get speaking opportunities, learning opportunities as a group, and practice opportunities with the group, a personal coach who gives you feedback and recommendation on how to improve, and daily micro-learning opportunities where you can challenge yourself and build on your core foundations. Also, to help with this, you have live classes that you can attend to clarify your doubts and learn your foundation and get them right. Great, let's continue with our introductions for an interview setting. The next thing you want to talk about is, of course, qualifications. What you've done, and again, make sure these are relevant to the job description, the context matters. For example, if you're in a managerial job, for instance, I did my MBA at Madras University. I did my bachelor's in zoology from Loyola, right? Again, depending on how relevant this is. Or let's say you've not graduated yet, you're still in college, then you could probably say, I'm in my third year of engineering at IIT or wherever it is that you're from. And of course, you could also add a little bit of achievement here because we spoke about professional achievements. If you're not a professional, then you could talk about your achievements in college, your academic achievements. You could say, I'm a gold medalist. I was the only gold medalist in the entire state. Or I was a student coordinator for the public speaking cell in my college. Whatever it is, make sure it's relevant and it shows that you bring in certain qualities that they may find appealing, right? So this is where you talk about your qualifications and academic achievements that are relevant to your job description. And of course, you also talk about your skills and achievements beyond this. What could these be? Talk about the certifications you've done. For example, I am a Cambridge certified English teacher, right? I have over 10 years of teaching experience, or I've taught for over 10 years. I've completed the CELTA from the British Council, and of course, I've developed curriculum and pedagogy for tens of companies and helped over 1,000 students learn, right? So notice how I made a very impactful impression. The assumption, of course, is that I'm interviewing for a training role, something related to teaching or heading a department, and that introduction gets them up to speed on who I am and how I can be a good fit very quickly. The final thing, of course, is closing. Bring it all together. Very important here is not what you are, but rather how you can help or how you can solve certain problems in the organization at the role that you're applying for. So be clear about how or what value you bring during the interview itself. So how can you do that? Talk about why you applied for this job. So say, for example, I love the learning philosophy that your company has and I have the same and I have a lot of vision for where we can take it from where we are now. If you're applying for an IT company, talk about how your experience managing databases can help you improve and streamline the current processes. That's a great way to show the value that you bring. Talk about why you feel you'll be a good fit. You could talk about how the experiences you've had in your life make you very suitable for the kind of role that you have, and the people who work there are also very similar to you, and therefore you could be a good fit. Or talk about how you're very passionate about what they're doing and how your experience gives proof for that. All these are great ways to really impress the interviewer in the first few minutes. And after that, once you've done that, everything else is just to check what you've said in your resume, in your covering letter, and in your introduction. And if you're not lying, well, it should be a breeze for you, right? So keep this in mind. Make sure you close correctly. Don't just talk about your qualifications, but also talk about how they come together for the job or the role that you've applied for. And beyond everything else, be respectful, be friendly, be open to any kind of feedback that they may give. Ask questions in the end. Do not feel like you are there interviewing them, or do not feel like that they are interviewing you. Remember that you're also there trying to figure out if you are a good fit for that position, right? That's pretty much the long and short of how to make a great impact in your interview while you introduce yourself. If you like the video, make sure you like and subscribe. Hit the bell notification to never miss a video like this. And of course, do not forget to try out the 30-day free trial with Capshine. You can do this by going to capshine.com or downloading the app. Thank you.